Morning, guys. What is up? How are you? I hope you're doing fantastic. We are on our way out the door because today is a very important day. Now you may be asking why today is a special day. Well, today is October 31st, and not only is it Halloween, great holiday, but today is also early voting in North Carolina where I live. So we are here at my voting station or at our polling station, so I'm gonna go vote. And to be honest, it's taken me about 20 minutes to find a parking spot. I did not expect it to be this busy. Early voting in North Carolina, typically you don't have a ton of voters that show up, so it's actually a little frustrating, but more importantly, it's really impressive to see all of these people taking time out of their day to come out and vote. So I'm gonna go vote, I'll be right back. Back home, back at the house. Just got done performing my civic duty and getting out and voting. Hey dogs. Now, here in America, you guys are part of our international audience. We have a lot of issues with voter apathy. Now, what we mean, or what I mean by voter apathy is that people feel like their votes don't count. Now, there are lots of things out there that could dissuade someone from voting, whether it's gerrymandering, whether it's just how politics is run, whether it's the special interest money that's in politics. There are lots of things that American voters see that they really just don't like. Now, with all the craziness happening in the media and American politics, it can be really, really easy to think that your vote doesn't count and to get discouraged and to keep yourself from voting. But for me, I have to remind myself that just two generations ago, my grandparents, my great-grandparents didn't even have the right to vote. And there were thousands of people across the country that fought for my right to be able to go and vote, to go make sure that my voice is heard every time we have an election. And this is especially important in these local elections, in these regional elections like we're voting in today. So today we voted for North Carolina Senate, for US Congress, and for some lower level local politicians and judgeships. These are the people who are going to shape policy at the local and regional level. These are the things that are going to affect us most closely and most directly. So it's incredibly important for us to go out and make our voices heard, no matter who we're voting for, to tell our local politicians how we want the country to go, how we want our city and state, and what direction we want our city and state to be moving in. And if we're not willing to take the time out of our day, take a few hours to go and vote and make our voices heard, then we are a bigger part of the problem than corrupt politics ever could be. So with all of that said, I really hope that this can encourage you guys to get out and vote in your state and local elections. They're so important for how we live our day-to-day lives. This is what's going to impact you. This is what impacts me. These are the things that are most important to us and will have the biggest and most radical changes on what we do in our day-to-day lives and how we are able to live. So get out and vote. There's still a lot of time. We are still in early voting, so it's only October 31st, and official voting day isn't until November 7th. So check your local voting locations, find out where you can vote, find out where you can make your voice heard, and get out there and get after it, guys. That's gonna be it for today's video. Thank you for watching, as always. I appreciate you. If you like this video, or if you went out and voted, smash that thumbs up button or leave a comment down below. Look, I don't care who you vote for, but get out there and make sure your voice is heard and that you participate in our democracy. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace.